With respect to corn fungicide choice, there are many agronomic and economic factors that go into that decision. Today, I'd like to discuss three of those. The first is the mode of action. Travapro and Mirvis Neo are three-way premixes. They each have tilt as a triazole, quadris as a strobilurin, and Travapro has the SDHI selotinol, and Mirvis Neo has the SDHI adepidin. Having a three-way premix in your fungicide helps ensure you don't have any gaps in disease spectrum and you don't have any gaps in residual control. A lot of other fungicides out there are either two-way premixes and missing one of those modes of action, or just the straight active ingredient of only one of those modes of action. The other factor I'd like to talk to you about is the amount of each active ingredient that you have in a product. It's not uncommon when fungicides mix two active ingredients together to reduce the rates of what that product would be when applied alone. This is not the case with Mirvis Neo or Travapro. When you apply these products at the full labeled rate at 13.7 ounces per acre, you're getting the full complement of tilt, you're getting the full complement of quadris, and in Travapro you're getting the full complement of the selotinol, and in Mirvis Neo you're getting the full complement of the adepidin. No rates are shaved when these products were pre-mixed together into a single product. And the last thing I'd like to talk about is application timing. These products have great application flexibility and can be used season long up until 30 days before harvest. Let's break that down into three buckets, V4 through V8, which we'll call the early season application. This is attractive for folks who want to maybe put it out with their post-emergent herbicide. This is a great time for early season disease control, but also help with that early season stress reduction. It seems every year we kind of have that dry spell mid-season, and this can help out when a fungicide's put on early season. Next, let's look at that mid-season application. Let's call it V8 through pre-tassel. This is another attractive time for folks who want to apply it with their own ground rig and want to let the corn get as tall as possible so they can maximize the amount of foliar coverage they can get with the fungicide. Just like all fungicides though, these fungicides have precautionary language on their labels about what kind of surfactants and adjuvants you're going to use. So if you're going to add something, please make sure it's safe. But the fungicides themselves in that V8 through tassel time, great choice. And the last time is going to be that VTR1 time. Year in, year out, that proves to be the most consistent timing for return on investment and overall yield production. The only time I would ever delay past that VTR1 time is if I'm a silage grower and I'm worried about ear rots. If that's the case, I'm going to want to use Mirvis Neo, and I'm going to apply it at silking for ear rot suppression.